Good morning. Myself, N.S. Gogre, Assistant Professor, Kikewa College of Horticulture, Nasik. The reason why I am preparing this video is a recent outbreak of coronavirus, that is COVID-19. As per instruction of Government of Maharashtra, I will request you all to stay at home and stay away at home and learn digitally by videos. Quickly, I am going to start my lecture on role deficiency symptoms, toxicity symptoms of micronutrients in continuation with deficiency symptoms of macronutrients. So micronutrient elements, what are the different micronutrients? That is, elements which is at low concentration, then balanced, then optimum, is regarded as a micronutrients, which produces certain deficiency symptoms, or less than 50 ppm, known as a micronutrient. Another different micronutrients, that is FEMN, ZN, boron, copper, molybdenum, copper, chlorine. These are termed as micronutrients. Then let's start with the deficiency symptoms of role and deficiency symptoms of iron. What is the role of iron? It is component of various cytochromes, that is cell organelles needed for photosynthesis. It is essential for nitrogen fixation, that is known as nitrate reductase activity and respiration process. What are the different deficiency symptoms of iron? For micronutrient, deficiency symptoms usually occur on younger leaves, that is newborn leaves. Deficiency symptoms always occur on younger leaves. And for macronutrient, deficiency symptoms occurs on older leaves. We have to study for a deficiency of micronutrients, it is always marked on younger leaves. So what are the deficiency symptoms of iron? That is intervenal fluorosis on that. Intervenal fluorosis on neuroth specifically. Neuroth means younger leaves. Because iron is immobile in nature, iron chloroses develops when soil pH is high. Iron chloroses develops when soil pH is ultimately high. These are just certain deficiency symptoms of iron. For overcoming the deficiency symptoms, we have to add certain fertilizers. But in respect to iron, we add a certain chelate known as iron chelates. What are these chelates? That is FeEDT, that is regarded as Fe330, which is stable at pH 7.0, and FeEDHA, that is Fe138, stable even pH is greater than 7.0. Because iron is usually developed in higher pH. So FeEDHA, Fe138 is needed most amount. For lower soil pH, iron is more useful in Fe form, that is a ferric form. The characteristic deficiency symptoms of iron is shown in particular figure. In figure 1, that is intervenal chlorosis on younger leaves. Then in figure 4, you study the deficiency in the intraminal fluorosis in the sample B, figure number 4. A is a there is a no deficiency in terms. It is a complete growth plant. And B mark is a deficiency in terms of iron, that is intraminal fluorosis. Okay. It is clearly represented in figure. How these iron chelates appear? IDT is a full form PDT, ethylene, diamond, tetraacetic acid. It is usually sometimes will be going to ask in your semi-trained examination. Then EDDHA, ethylene, diamond, dihydroxyphenyl acetic acid. Okay, this is the for correction. Then chelates directly made available to the unavailable plant. Then we study the deficiency, a role and deficiency toxicity symptoms of manganese. What is the role of manganese? A required chlorophyll synthesis. And magnesium is involved in synthesis of chlorophyll. It is required for chlorophyll synthesis, manganese. Photo evolution during photosynthesis. It is activator of some enzymes. Deficiency symptoms. Motile chlorosis between main veins of new leaves. That is motile chlorosis. That is motile chlorosis can be presented in pictorial form later. That is similar to near epichlorosis. Then what are the different toxicity symptoms of manganese? That is chlorosis on new growth with small neurons and dark spots. There's a toxicity of manganese because it is involved in chlorophyll synthesis. Excess of manganese causes chlorosis on new growth with higher dark patches. Usually deficiency occurs at high pH and toxicity occurs at lower pH. For correction measures, we add certain fertilizers that is termed as manganese sulfate, that is MnA sulfur. MnEDT, that is manganese chelate used for high pH soils. This role of manganese deficiency in terms of symptoms and correction measures. For then second macronutrient is boron. The role of boron is involved in carbohydrate metabolism, essential for flowering, pollen germination, and nitrogen metabolism. Deficiency is marked on new growth in distorted and malformed patches. Flowering and fruit set gets depressed. Roots and tubers get distorted. Toxicity. Twig dieback, fruit splitting, leaf edges gets burned. These are certain toxicity symptoms of boron. Deficiency of boron causes cracking in pomegranate. It is a difficult disorder of boron. So to overcome the deficiency of boron, we need to add a certain borax and calcium borate. Then another macronutrient is zinc. The role of zinc, that is, it is involved in protein synthesis, RAA synthesis, that is indole acetic acid synthesis. What are the deficiencies in terms of zinc? Usually occurs in calcareous soil in a high pH. It produces certain growth suppressions, reduced internode length, rosetting, bush type appearance. Rosetting is only bush type appearance. Intraminal chlorosis on younger leaves, because zinc is almost immobile in tissue. What are toxicity symptoms of zinc? Walker site locus, growth reduction, and lip fluorosis are typical toxicity symptoms of zinc. We can see the deficiency symptoms according to concentration in millimolar very well. Okay. The next micronutrient, that is molybdenum. The role of molybdenum is required for nitrate reductase activities and vitamin synthesis. What is nitrate reductase? Conversion of nitrate form into amide form. That is, inactive forms get converted by activity of nitrate reductase bacteria into NH2 form. Root knot bacteria also requires molybdenum. So, what are the deficiency symptoms? Pale green color of leaves, curved end leaves, because molybdenum is also immobile in nature, trap leaf and broad leaf plants, usually occurs at low pH, toxicity of molybdenum, fluorosis with orange color pigmentation is a specific deficiency, a specific toxicity symptoms of molybdenum ore. For correction of deficiency symptoms of molybdenum, we need to add sodium molybdate as a fertilizer. Then next micronutrient is the copper. What is the role of copper? Essential component of several enzymes required in chlorophyll synthesis. Then carbohydrate metabolism, inhalation. Deficiency cause rosette growth or witch's broom like appearance. Deficiency causes rosette egg growth or witch's broom like appearance. Toxicity usually chlorosis. And for correction of deficiency, rosette or witch's broom like appearance, we need to add a certain fertilizer that is known as a copper sulfate. Then chlorine. It is in order for a role of chlorine, it is in order in photosynthetic oxygen regulation. Then deficiency, normally not existing, only experimentally include. Normally deficiency not existing. Toxicity, leaf margin chlorosis, necrosis on leaves are typical toxicity symptoms of chlorine. Fertilizer. For chlorine, we never applied any fertilizer. Chlorine is a known, so that's why chlorine is known as a byproduct. Molybdenum deficiency produces vitellin cauliflower, particularly vitellin cauliflower. Okay, that's it. It is all about role, deficiency symptoms, toxicity symptoms and correction measures and pictorial representation of deficiency of micronutrients. Thank you so much.